29th Winter Universiade continues in the Siberian city of Krasnoyarsk, and in particular here at the Biathlon Academy complex, where it's really been rocking this morning with great music, and the crowd is very much looking forward to this event. It is the pursuit for both women and men today, and the women are due to start very shortly. We're having a quick glance at some of the hot contenders as they go through the traditional rifle check to ensure that everything is okay. So it's a big welcome to you wherever you might be watching from. It's a beautiful day, as you'll see very soon. And conditions are once again absolutely outstanding for this event. Over what a lot of the competitors are claiming to be quite a tough course. So -5, there is a wind again from the southwest. That's the typical direction from which it comes, but it's nothing out of the ordinary. 31 starters. And after the sprint yesterday, of course, we determine at what stages the athletes will leave the start area. The winner of the gold in the sprint was Ekaterina Moshkova of Russia. In fact, the first 6 athletes were from Russia, and then 3 from the Czech Republic. Look at that beautiful blue sky. That's as lovely as it's been here. It is a fabulous day. Last big deep breath from Ekaterina Moshkova, who has won the gold in the sprint yesterday and 2 days previously a silver medal in the individual. She will lead them off, but she will hear the sound of the skis of the woman behind her just 3 seconds away. It starts the women's pursuit, and just 3 seconds separating the first 2 to leave the gates. Moshkova, Kasakevich, that's the order in which they finished in the sprint yesterday. Kasakevich is going to be right up on top of Moshkova, so it'll be a tactical race. 25 seconds down is Voronina. Close behind her is Gubulova, so the first 4 are away. Quickly off is Vasdetsnova, and Kaplina will be the next. And Kaplina will be wearing the number 6. There she goes now. So all the Russians are now on the course in the women's pursuit. What can the other nations do to prevent a repeat of what we've seen in the 2 previous women's races? And that is, all 3 podium positions have been filled by Russian competitors. Will they take turns out there at leading, or will Kasakevich just allow Moshkova to do all the hard work? Moshkova, Kasakevich. I wonder if we'll ever see a shot on the course where they are not linked together. And maybe too for these couple of Russians, Voronina and Gubulova. This is the first time we've seen shafts of sunlight hitting the snow. That's making it extraordinarily attractive. And in the background there, the gold off the trees. It's a beautiful background in Krasnoyarsk. It's so picturesque today. No snow falling, and hasn't for quite some time. Temperature only just below freezing. The snow is perfect. You see where it's been manicured during the morning. Yes, it really is fabulous here, with so many wearing some of the national costumes. There's been fabulous displays and events celebrating Krasnoyarsk here into the number 1 slot. First in Now, coach for Russia, one of the coaches, Alexander Selifanov. He was talking earlier about how the conditions are better today than they have been. The shooters have already expressed the fact that they think it's ideal. And while we see the wind indicators moving left to right on the range, he believes that's not an effective wind at all. It won't worry them. And so they should be shooting to their maximum here. Wow. Very interesting what we've seen so far. We're just talking about how good the conditions are, and we've seen Kaplina have a miss. Now, having completed the five shots, Vasnetsova, Kaplina, some of them will be visiting the red zone, which means from here they carry on left and go around this penalty loop. As we see the athlete to the left doing that, that was Kaplina. In the meantime, Vasnetsova and Gubulova, they are together and separated by just 1 second. This is Tamara Voronina, the bronze medalist. She's in number three there, bronze medalist in the sprint and fourth in the individual. So within range of Kazakevich, who had a fabulous silver medal in the sprint yesterday, but was within touching distance of the gold. Kazakevich, she looked strong in that first lap, didn't she? Going into the chute, she was just hovering around Moshkova, not doing much work, but looked strong. And now this is where she excels, up the hills. Quite a good climb here in which she can show her ability and maybe put some pressure on the rest. And then we've got other very good climbers such as Kaplina, but her shooting has let her down in the two events to date. The leader in the women's pursuit. Daylight between these two and the rest as well. Plenty of optimism among the crowd here at Krasnoyarsk. Loving this complete dominance of both the men's and women's biathlon. It's important that with these three so close together that they hit these targets. Who will fire first? Kazakevich. Moshkova. Voronina. No red marks yet. Kazakevich blasted away through those. Moshkova has had a miss. Voronina clean. It's starting to become extremely intriguing. Kazakevich, she will extend that lead now. Moshkova was her hottest challenger, but now it will be Voronina. Vasnetsova continues to shoot clean. Moshkova has come out of the penalty loop area and is on her way. Seconds. And Kazakevich will now try to enhance that lead. Keep putting pressure on the rest. Kaplina, another miss. We're down the field a wee bit now to some of those who were middle starters. number 30 is Kerber of Canada. Following her, Mertza of the Republic of Moldova. And sliding up in amongst those is the leader in this competition. And as she glides past, those others must be wondering how on earth she's doing that. But they'll also be aware that not far behind and just coming into view now is Veronina. Out of the shooting, the second visit to the range, Kazakevich had a 9-second advantage. Veronina has put some work in and has closed that gap a little bit, just 2 seconds. And Veronina has been shooting well, perfect so far, through the 5.2. Irina Kazakevich, well, looking so relaxed and assured. About a 10-second advantage, the last split we saw. This woman, though, is the best and most consistent of the shooters. And she knows, as does Kazakevich, that if the leader misses and has to do another penalty loop of 20 seconds or so, then it could be a change in the front. Slows to a standstill, slides in. Now this is the standing shoot. Will we see some drama unfold here? They are very close together, and so she is totally aware that Moshkova and Veronina have slotted in not far from her. Oh, Kazakevich has a miss. Kazakevich and Moshkova. Watch now, Moshkova. Veronina. Oh, this is going to be intriguing now. Vasnetsova is into the range, but the leading three are off. Vasnetsova has a couple of misses. She goes into the range and now out of the penalty area. Here comes Kazakevich. And the others weren't able to make that impact that they'd hoped. They wanted to go clean. Kazakevich has a miss. Moshkova now has had three misses. Veronina, who was clear through shoot one and two, was the one that we thought might have made up some ground here. About. Oh, it's almost clear air, isn't it, Beth? She came around that bend and starts the climb where last time through the circuit, you see how strong she was. Now with that advantage, and she knows how far behind the nearest challenger is. She's proved herself at the shooting range. Two misses. But she's kept the pressure on the others. Now Moshkova, 16 seconds behind coming out of the range. She is working hard. But we saw that happen too from Veronina. And it took its toll when it came to pulling the trigger. Into the crouch, conserving a little bit of energy. Relaxing slightly, but ever so slightly. With the knowledge that there's this climb ahead. And it's a climb that Kazakevich seems to be thriving on. The chase from Moshkova. She won the sprint, but only just over the woman in front of her. Veronina, two visits to the range and was perfect. And then two misses in the standing third shoot. 9 seconds behind. You can afford to take some time. If she's accurate, she's got it. Even if she misses one, or she misses one, that's still, she has been skiing so brilliantly. She doesn't need to miss again. If she gets this one, she'll be feeling confident, and she does. Moshkova needs to nail this, she does. So, it's all on over the final lap. There goes Moshkova. To her left, or to our left, we just saw Kazakevich enter the penalty zone. Veronina doesn't help her chances. Up the testing climb with less than a kilometre to go is our new leader, Ekaterina Moshkova. Her lead was 19 seconds. And the woman in second place now, who was challenging her and in fact was leading all the way until the last 2 kilometres, Kazakevich. She's making no impression. That miss must have had a psychological damaging effect on her. Going into that shoot, Kazakevich had a 10-second advantage. She missed one, went into the penalty zone, and Moshkova has made the most of it. Herself every opportunity to win something other than bronze, but with some flawless shooting at the range the first two times, but then she let herself down. Two misses on the third, and another one on the fourth. Tucked up, looking confident. No problems now for this woman, who has just kept the pressure on the leaders. She breaks into a smile. It's another gold medal for Moshkova. Another gold medal for Russia. Time to salute the crowd and thank them for their support. The winner of the women's pursuit. Magnificent performance from Ekaterina Moshkova. Amidst all the pressures and the challenges that were thrown at her by Irina Kazakevich, they embrace, not for the first time in this competition, Moshkova the gold in the sprint as well, Kazakevich the silver. So the seedings have worked out well. And a second bronze for Tamara Veronina. As she climbs up now, receives the accolades of the audience. The Russian flag's evident. And she pushes to the line for third place. There it is again, and this is history at the Winter Universiade. One nation has won all the medals in the women's pursuit. And that nation is the host nation, Russia. Vaznetsova. Fourth, and no one has broken the Russians at all. It does look as though it's going to be Russia 1 through to 6, as it has been in every event with the women so far. 1-6 in the sprints, 1-6 in the individual. And with Kaplina crossing now in sixth place, that means it is Russia 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the third event at the Winter Universiade in Krasnoyarsk. Medal ceremony now for the women's pursuit. And Tamara Voronina is the winner of the bronze medal. That's her second bronze. Kitakevich was the leader for the majority of this race and receives the silver medal.
The gold medalist of the 29 Winter Universiade Krasnoyarsk 2019, representing Russian Federation, Екатерина Машкова.
Calm and composed under pressure, Moshkova wins her second gold of the Winter Universiade in Krasnoyarsk. Well, I must say that any event such as the Winter Games can't operate without volunteers. Oh, here we go. Look at this. This is Stanislav Ilyin, who's a volunteer within the broadcasting area where we're situated, obviously, and he has just proposed to his girlfriend, Nicole Bakanova, who works in the accreditation area. And fortunately, I think for Stanislav, she has said yes. Isn't that fantastic? So the host athletes continue to shine at the 2019 Winter Universiade in Krasnoyarsk. Thank you for watching and farewell.